interior naturally received much care and precise work. Makrutzki said that the team didn't really have a specific look in mind, except that they wanted to have elements of the exclusive Series 911 and maintain the look and feel of the 993. The team went through various samples and would look over the new 911 to get ideas and cherry-picked what felt right. Aside from the extensive use of carbon fiber and fancy perforated leathers, the Project Gold car features completely custom front seats not shared with other 993s. Makrutzki also told us a story about the headliner of the car. It's a leather headliner made in two layers. The outer one is black with perforated stripes, and under that is yellow leather that shows through. The team wanted everything in the car to feel as close to a car from 1998 as possible, and that led it to use a sewing machine from that era so the stitches had the right length and pattern. Each time they tried to finish the stitching for the stripes, they found that the stitches were curving one way. They couldn't find any way to fix the machine, but they eventually figured out the exact amount of curve, and factored that into the line to follow when sewing it up, leading to nice straight stripes. It may be a while before we see another car like this come out of Porsche. We learned from Makrutzki that the car was entirely built by the Porsche Classic restoration team. The team comprises the people that are working on restorations for paying customers, so they already have plenty to keep them busy. Porsche itself hasn't announced any plans for future projects either, and it sounds as though there aren't really any other production chassis laying around like with this 993. With this much care put into it, the Project Gold 911 Turbo ought to make its new owner very happy, even if it can't be driven on public roads. How much the owner will have to pay has yet to be seen, since the car will be auctioned off by RM Sotheby's on October 27th at the auction house's 70th anniversary of Porsche auction. We imagine it will be pretty pricey considering that it is a one-of-one car with no announced successors. It's an air-cooled 911 and the proceeds will be going to charity.